Hello and welcome back to Blackwatch Intel. My name is Crashy, and today we're doing kind of a follow-up video after watching today's coffee break or coffee time from One Amongst Many. So if you haven't checked that out, I have the thumbnail here on the screen, and you should definitely check out that series because it's a really fun kind of break from the structured type of content that he does on his channel. And it's actually a lot like what I do, where I just kind of open up the mic and just kind of talk on a specific topic. Now, today's topic that he did was particularly interesting, and I don't want to spoil it for you. He's kind of talking about ranked, and it's a much more serious conversation, but it kind of sparked an idea, and I was listening to it on the drive home, and he essentially is talking a lot about what Blizzard, you know, thinks is acceptable and what is and isn't acceptable in the eyes of the community, and what should and shouldn't be acceptable in the eyes of the community in terms of the competitive ladder. And I think there's something that's kind of going around that the majority of people agree with, at least to some degree, and it's definitely something we've talked here on the channel, and that's about one-tricking. And all in all, there are a few different, you know, kind of decisions that people make and actions that people take and, you know, the way they're acting in the competitive ladder that should be condemned and that should be deemed unacceptable and something that the community or that Blizzard will not tolerate. Now, that said, it's kind of a weird situation because I don't know if Blizzard's ever going to step forward and say, hey, you know what? We've been thinking about it and one-tricking isn't acceptable. I don't know if they're ever going to do that because at the end of the day, that hurts a small percentage of their players who truly want to hop on the game and play their favorite hero. And, well, I do kind of sympathize and understand the argument of them spending their money and wanting to play the game they want to play, but at the same time, I sympathize very strongly with the fact that this is competitive, and that's not really how competitive is meant to be played. I mean, it's just not. You will never see a one-trick professional Overwatch player. Now, you may see an Overwatch player that has the majority of their playtime on a single hero, like, say, a Lucio player in Overwatch League or something like that. But there's never, I mean literally never, going to be a one-trick Symmetra or like a one-trick Genji professional player. It's just never going to happen. That's not how the game is literally meant to be played. And so, in a way, I think we already have said, at least by understanding the game, that one-tricking is unacceptable. But that's not a literal stance from the developers, and the community seems split on it, and you know, the one trick players want to play the way they want to play, and the rest of us want to play the way we feel the game's supposed to be played. And ultimately, when you have a 35 million player base, there's a lot of different perspectives and opinions that go into, you know, different issues and different topics like this. So I had an idea, and that's kind of the root of this video, and it's something that I still haven't even kind of thought enough about to, you know, present in a great way, but it is something that maybe, you know, some of y'all listening out there, anybody that kind of catches wind of this could actually help me even come up with. And it kind of made me think back to CSGO, and it kind of made me think to the idea of voting to kick someone, you know? And obviously that's not a great option, because if you have a competitive game, you don't want to be down a teammate. You don't want to have a bot sitting in place for your teammate, and for a game like Overwatch, that really doesn't work. Now, it's not great in CSGO, you don't want to get rid of a teammate and have a bot, but it's not the worst thing in the world, I guess, and I don't really know what else they could do. But what if there was an option to vote to force your teammate to change their hero? Now, hear me out. Before you start typing in the comment section how stupid that is, and how restricting people is dumb, and, you know, they're never going to do that, hear me out. What this will do is it'll take the decision away from Blizzard and it'll put it in the hands of the community. Because you'll get in a game, and for hypothetical scenarios, let's say that for that vote to pass, to force someone to change their hero, the vote has to pass with 4 or 5 votes. You know, almost unanimous. Everybody on the team, 4 or 5 of the team members have to say, yeah, you know, Crashy's really not helping us on this hero. I think we all want to agree that he needs to swap. And I don't know how it would happen, because it would either have to happen in between rounds, because the player would have to be in spawn, and you wouldn't want to just do it in the middle of the game, But at the same time, it doesn't force Blizzard's hand to say, you know what, one tricking is unacceptable. But what it does do is gives the community and the player base the option to say, you know what, this is stupid. Like, this guy is always in my games, and all he does is play Symmetra, and you know what, guys, I don't think he's helping us out. And the other team, you know, the people on your team say, you know what, he's not helping us out. Let's call a vote whenever we get on defense. And what it'll do is it will make that player either, one, understand that this is going to start happening a lot if that was the case, because it is going to be a game-by-game basis, you know, player-to-player basis. People in the lobby are going to have to agree on this, and it will slowly, over time, start eliminating one-tricking, because the one-tricks are going to start losing this battle to the community. They're going to start losing the ability to win that vote and to convince someone that, you know, they shouldn't be kicked off their character. Now, here's a flaw that I can think of. Well, what if the one trick is queued with someone and that person just always says no? That could be a flaw, definitely, which is why I said maybe it should have to be 4 votes or half the team or something like that. You know what I mean? And again, this is probably never, ever going to happen. So we have to kind of think a little ridiculously and also be a little realistic. But I don't know. What do we do with this situation? How do we get rid of one tricking without forcing Blizzard's hand? Because it's not even something they want to do, because if it was, they would have done it already. So I feel like taking that power away from Blizzard and putting it in the hands of the people that are in the games, that are the ones dealing with it, would be more acceptable. But again, there's always issues with things like this, with different systems that you try to build in. You know, how could the one trick player exploit that? Well, he could queue with people and they could just vote no, and then the one trick player keeps one tricking. But hell, at least the solo queue one-trick players might not have that option. And over time, it would make them have to change their hero. Literally, in the game, it would built in make them have to change. So now what happens? What do you guys see when the one-trick doesn't get their hero? What do? They throw, right? I mean, a lot of the time, it's true. They pick something else and they just start throwing. Well, guess what? This is still a bannable, reportable offense. So what do? We take away the ability for them to get away with the BS that they're doing now, because we've put the power in the community's hands and we're forcing them to change their hero, and now the one trick has the option. Well, do I run the risk of getting reported and potentially banned because I'm going to be a thrower, or do I quit one tricking? This is a thought that I was kind of like blown away when I thought of, and again, it's not perfect. I don't know how it could be perfect. I don't know if it will ever see the light of day, but it's something to think about. So let me know what you think in the comment section below. Please do not leave it up leaving a like and subscribe for future videos. I appreciate it again, and I'll see you on the next video. Sparks that I'm setting free. Does the beat take you over? Just